What's going on, everybody? Welcome back. FantasyTeamAdvisors.com, bringing home the bacon NBA DFS video. It is Thursday. It is November 21st. We only have four games. I know this video is coming out later. If you were in our Discord, which you can find the link down below, I'm sick. I don't have a voice in the morning. Like, it's gone. And I tried to do a video and I could not. So we're here. If you're new to the channel, welcome. Congratulations to all the winners. I've been getting a lot of your winning lineups over in our Discord, which is completely free. Find the link down below. And anyone who is new, hit the bell notification, hit the subscribe button, because we have giveaways every single day. If this video gets at least 50 likes, you leave a like on the video, you leave a comment, and you are a subscriber, you have a chance to win a free week of FTA Plus. That includes a week of MMA, NBA, PGA, and NFL, obviously. If the video gets at least 100 likes, you have a chance at a free month, 150 likes, a free year, 200 or more likes on the video, a chance at a lifetime pass. On top of that, anytime a video gets those, we have that one. But we always have a giveaway if it doesn't reach that. Just like yesterday's video did not reach it, but we have a keyword. We say the keyword out loud somewhere in this video. Listen for that keyword, type it in, and have a chance to win a free week of FTA Plus. You technically could get that. You could get that twice. You could win for the video. You could also win for the keyword if you're listening for it. So we are going to have a giveaway. We are going to see who the winner is. So the keyword yesterday was Keith, or Keith Morrison for Dateline. Adam Ponce, love the content. Do you have a VIP section? So I've been thinking about putting a membership here on YouTube. If that's something you guys would be interested in, let me know. But we do have a VIP section, FTA Plus, over on the website, FantasyTeamAdvisor.com. You can check that out as well. Did not have the keyword, but thanks for the support, Adam. I know you will be back either today or the next video and the next video. So, Anthony, awesome breakdown. Did not have the keyword. Keyword was Keith. Keyword, key phrase for the day. So we'll keep doing it. See, he could have won twice had it happened to him. So we just re-roll it. I love Keith Morrison. Richard Cly 3, congratulations, you are the winner. Please email me dfshelp1@gmail.com. That is dfshelp1@gmail.com. Let me know if you have a username on the website. If you do not, let me know a username and email you would like, and we will get you set up. So what we're going to do, normally when we have five games on the slate, we give you three top, three mid, and three value picks at each position. But we only have four games on this slate. So we're just going to give you some picks with our early projections. Now, these can and will change throughout the day. We've got a lot of questionable guys. We've got guys already ruled out, which will bump up some of the value plays here. After that, we will build a Fanduel lineup, a DraftKings lineup, and a Yahoo lineup. So using our sponsor, Outlier.bet, we can see, and you can find the link down below, we can see what we've got going on. Detroit is a favored team. I think this might be the first time they've been favored this year. -1.5, over under 220. You got Minnesota versus Toronto. Minnesota being an 8.5-point favorite, 225.5. You got Utah versus the Spurs. The Spurs only being a 2.5-point favorite because Wimby is out, 223.5. And then we got the Magic at the Lakers. Lakers being a 4.5-point favorite, 216.5. Luckily, for the most part, all the games are close. Not, as of now, not double-digit blowouts. So we should be pretty good when building these lineups. So let's take a look. Each position, we still got questionable guys. We had out guys. Let's see some of these projections. Now, these can and will change. Maybe by the time you watch this video, go check out FantasyTeamAdvisors.com. The NBA tab, we've got odds, bets, fantasy points allowed by position, chalk plays, and then simulations and projections, and a cheat sheet as well. So looking at the point guard position, the top one I've got projected right now is LaMelo Ball. Now, he was benched last game, so that always a little bit scary. Got him projected right around 48 to 50 fantasy points. Anthony Edwards at Toronto, got him projected, same thing, 48 to 50. Cade Cunningham, right around 46 fantasy points. Go down a little bit, Keontae George at 31 fantasy points, Austin Reeves at 31, and Colin Sexton at 31 as well. And then a couple more lower-end guys that might be value for this position, just depending on what kind of value we're going to get today. Chris Paul, got him right around 38 fantasy points, but a value for his price. Davion Mitchell against Minnesota, right around 26 fantasy points is what we're looking at. So let's move to the shooting guard position now. So looking at these, looking at projections, top one that I'm looking at Brandon Miller, 34 to 38 fantasy points. We do have Jaden Ivey at 33. Grady Dick at 30 fantasy points. Go down a little bit. Steven Castle was value before. We've got him about 29 fantasy points. Julian Chapagny, right around 26. Now, I did have a video where people were like, do you even watch basketball? You can't pronounce some of the names. No, I don't watch basketball, but we win. I don't need to watch basketball to know how to do this. I do MMA, and we've been winning. I can't pronounce MMA names for the most part. Hockey, good luck. Good luck to me. That's why we have nicknames. Julian Chimpagni at 26 fantasy points. Mr. Champagne, Mr. Worldwide Champagne. Got him right around 27 fantasy points. A couple of lower-end guys. KCP right around 20 fantasy points if he gets some run. And Nikhil Alexander-Walker right around 15 to 20 fantasy points. But if we're looking for some value at shooting guard today, Steven Castle's the highest valued guy I have. We're looking at the right around the 30 range. You could go down a little bit, look at Trey Mann right around 22 fantasy points. You could look at Jaden Ivey right around 32. These are some value plays that we are definitely looking at. And it's not necessarily low-end projected guys. It's the value that they get at the position, whether or not it's DVP, whether or not it's the Vegas odds. It's all wrapped into one. So we are looking at small forward now. LeBron James at the top, right around 50 fantasy points. Franz Wagner right around 47. Did let us down the other day, but I think he could come back strong here. Wouldn't be surprised if he gets 50+. We got RJ Barrett right around 40. Lauri Markkanen right around 36. Couple of lower end ones. Dalton Knecht. I mean, if he gets the run, he is still 5,100. He obviously put up 49.75 back-to-back 45+ games. He made 9 three-pointers last game against Utah. He made 5 the game before that. He's still cheap in this game. I love Dalton Knecht. Probably my favorite play of the day. At his price, I love this. Hopefully they just don't, you know, sit him for no reason at all. He looks like he has LeBron's endorsement, so that should be pretty good there. If we're looking at for biggest value plays here at the small forward position, Cody Martin right around 22 fantasy points I could look at. Harrison Barnes also right around 22 fantasy points. You could look at Jaden McDaniels right around 22 as well. So let's move to the power forward position, trying to get some of these projections out there for you. So looking at the highest projected for power forward, Julius Randle right around 42 fantasy points. Miles Bridges, as long as he's in there, right around 35 fantasy points. John Collins at 33. Tobias Harris, 31. Naz Reid at 26. The biggest value plays we can find here. Naz Reid's one of the biggest ones at 26 to 28 fantasy point range. Grant Williams could be a cheaper option at 25 fantasy points. And then Tristan Da Silva, if he gets in there, this is the only thing if he's going to get in there for Orlando. But it depends if the game gets out of hand. At his price of under 4K, if we could get 18 to 22 out of him, that is what I would look at. That's right around the range we're looking at. So Tristan Da Silva could be a sneaky, hopefully under-owned play for us today. Then we look at the center position. Anthony Davis questionable. I think it's probably going to turn into probable in play. He's probable. He's always going to have the questionable tag. Got him right around 52 to 55 fantasy points. Jakob Poeltl right around 37 to 40 fantasy points. Rudy Gobert right around 35 to 40 range. I'll go down list a little bit. Jalen Duren about 33. Zach Collins 31. Charles Bassey about 25 fantasy points. Now, if you're looking for some value at center today, Bassey's one at 25. Kyle Filipowski, I don't mind him, about 22 fantasy points. Jonathan Mogbo, right around 16. Drew Eubanks, right around 16 to 20 as well. I'm probably not paying down at center, but I definitely think you guys could. So, there you have it. Those are the projections, early projections. They can and probably will change a little bit by the time you watch this video, but hopefully it is very helpful for you. Now, we are going to build a DraftKings lineup, FanDuel, and Yahoo, so let's do just that. So looking at point guard, now these can and probably do change a little bit if these questionable guys are in or out. So Scotty Barnes missed 11 games, probably on some sort of restriction, being as how he's missed 11 games, did practice yesterday. So that's always a plus for practicing. But even if he is back, I am scared that he'll be on some sort of minutes restriction, and I don't want to pay $8,700. So I am going to go down to Chris Paul. Now, one of the value guys, he is questionable, but he is probable. I wish they would just change it from questionable to probable. I don't know why they don't do that. Stephen Castle is one, or Stefan Castle. You guys let me know how to pronounce it if I'm pronouncing it wrong, which doesn't affect how I get projections with the algorithm and everything like that. We do have Miles Bridges, is questionable. Something to look at. Has been downgraded from probably, okay, so he's been downgraded since I made this. So we're going to keep him out of there right now, and we're going to see what we can build. So I thought he was going to play, but they have changed a little bit. Rudy Gobert is in there at center, guard, depending on what we're looking at. Well, let's go forward first. Wagner. Okay, we'll put him at power forward so then we can get him there. I want to put Bassey in there. I think he's a cheap option. Got a great DVP matchup. So now we're at 6,000 to go a guard and a forward, which we could go a lot of places. But I think I'm going to go Dalton Knecht at 51. Now that allows us a $6,900 forward if we want. So Brandon Miller, game log wise, 47. I mean, he's done well. He's going up against Detroit in a game where Detroit is favored. Maybe Detroit's up. I'm going to go Brandon Miller. So that's my lineup. Paul, Castle, Markkanen, Wagner, Gobert, Knecht, Miller, and Bassey. So once that is done, we are going to go over to FanDuel to build you a lineup. So looking at this, really depends on what we can get to build. And the salary's a little bit different. We know this. There's only four games. You got to get a little creative. I think this is kind of more of those boomer bust type lineups because that's what we have when we have a four-game small slate. And when it's a small slate like this, it's always kind of stupid. The scoring has been absolutely ridiculous. That is what I hate. The scoring lately, I don't know if it's whether or not it's... So I don't play on FanDuel, but on DraftKings, the other, like a week ago, it was 500, which is absolutely wild. So let's go Davion Mitchell in a matchup where they're going to be behind. Chris Paul is probable. Change that from game time decision to probable. I don't know why they don't. Anthony Edwards I want in there. I want Castle in there as well. I want to get Wagner. Franz, not Mo. I want to get Randall because all of these guys we've talked about. Excuse me. Mr. Champagne, Mr. Worldwide. I want to get Champagne in there. Now we're at one power forward and one center. I'm looking at Collins. Zach Collins. I want to see if he's probable or... So he is one that might be out. So let's not go with him because I don't want to build you a lineup and then he's out. So we're going to go Jakob Poeltl. And then we are looking at power forward. And we're looking at what we can get for 6,000. So basically Zach Collins down. These guys are all questionable or whether or not they're out. So Grant Williams against Detroit. Keontae George against San Antonio. Grady Dick against Minnesota. Now, Grady let us down, yes, at his price. He let us down against Indy, which I love that matchup for him. Everybody did. I love that matchup for him, and he let us down. Keldon Johnson against Utah. I think I'm going to go with Keldon Johnson. So Davion Mitchell all the way down to Jakob Poeltl. Now, this is where it gets interesting. We are going to do Yahoo, which we have had a lot of success, and you guys have been showing your winning lineups on our Discord for Yahoo, which has been amazing. So we're just going to start this fast and ready. Let's just go. Cade Cunningham in a matchup where they're actually supposed to be ahead. I don't mind that. Grady Dick let us down. But again, on Yahoo, the pricing's a little bit more lenient. Not hugely. But you can see the kind of lineup we can build using that. We got Mr. Champagne, like I said, only at $15. Randall here at power forward. At forward, Franz Wagner is in here. He's making every single lineup, I believe. Bassey is another one at 10, which now allows us $24 for utility. Now, this is where I wanted to see if we're able to build it. So, obviously, we like Dalton Knecht. He's at 15. So, you could put Knecht at 15. And then if you want to go through and change somebody like Grady Dick, who let us down before, maybe we don't want him. Jaden Ivey. You could look at Austin Reeves, Jalen Suggs. So I'll go Jaden Ivey at $28. We've left two on the table. Cunningham all the way down to Knecht. Let's have a great Thursday. We've already put out the Thursday Night Football Showdown breakdown and our favorite Thursday Night Football, I think it was plus 825 odds on DraftKings. We put out a four-player same-game parlay. So if you want to check that out, make sure you check that out here at the end of the video. Those are the lineups. Those are the breakdown. Make sure you come back tomorrow. Hopefully, I have a voice. Hopefully, the video is out a little bit earlier than it was today. Good luck. And as always, the keyword of the day, medicine, because I'm on it, because I am sick. That's what I've got. Good luck. As always, let's bring home some bacon. Peace.